Hello, you're watching Telecom TV. I'm Martin Warwick. We're here at the TM Forum's Digital Transformation World, and I'm talking with Michal Medrala of Comarch. Michal, good to see you, and thanks for talking to us. This year, Comarch celebrates a quarter of a century in the business, and we've seen lots and lots of things happen during that 25 years. Things have changed out of all recognition, really. And now we're going into yet another transformation, an entire digital transformation of the network. I'd like to ask you this. How do you at Comarch see your role in that network transformation and the resultant evolution of OSS?
OSS is becoming more and more important during the revolution of technologies and evolution of technologies. It has to support not only the new ones, new upcoming technologies like 5G, like virtualization and VSDN, but also legacy networks. So this is the very important role to be able to support hybrid networks. And that's what we are doing with our OSS.
One of the most interesting aspects of the new technologies is automation. How does Comarch address the concept of zero-touch maintenance and optimization? And what approach are you taking? How are you doing it?
The automation is more and more important in the industry right now. There are initiatives like zero-touch service and network provisioning. Comarch is the participant of that. So we are following standards. We are looking into the market, how to support it. And there are two very important artifacts of automation and zero-touch provisioning, which is understanding the network and understanding the devices. And second is understanding the processes, having the the event database of events of the network. And Comarch is supporting that with two important modules. It's known event database of the network, and it's also the configuration management framework, which allows us to talk to all kind of network, all kind of devices, and to communicate with them. Zero-touch optimization, maintenance, and provisioning is becoming more and more important, especially if we are talking about 5G services. And through the recent years, Comarch has implemented automation of complete life cycle of network provisioning and optimization, and we are ready to launch zero-touch in our customer networks.
What do your customers tell you are the main challenges facing them at the moment as far as OSS is concerned, and how do you help them to solve those problems?
Yeah, the main challenges in the OSS area right now is to be able to rapidly adjust OSS functions according to running technologies. So to respond in the timely manner, to support new services, and only those players will win, which are well-defined architecture, well-defined framework. And we are happy, very happy to say that we are following TM Forum framework from several years, and this was a good decision.
Can we turn to next generation networks? Where are we on the evolutionary road? Is there an end point, or is it just an endless journey?
This is a good question. I think that it will never finish. It's a mixture of reinventing the wheel and running of new technologies, and the show must go on, and we'll be taking part all the time, and we are happy to do it.
Final question. What do telcos tell you that they want from OSS now, and do they know what they're going to need in the future?
That's the good question, because currently this is the good time about virtualization and 5G, and I think that the current operators has reached the border of their old legacy OSSs, which cannot support new functions. And it's a bit as a snowball, which is rising and rising. And if they can't support it quickly, the network will not wait. It's also changing. And it's exactly the time to change their OSS to the new architecture, to microservice architecture. New OSS has to be more and more configurable, and operators should be able to configure its new services by themselves quickly. So that's how we are addressing that. We are happy to provide innovative OSS based on the standards.
Michal Medrala, thanks very much.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.